Welcome to the special episode of Algae Corner as part of the mini-series event on Aquashade. Here we're talking about flipping the switch on algae. Now let me start with a couple similar examples to help paint the picture for you. What happens when you're vacuuming and one of your kids pulls the plug? Stops working, right? What about when that space heater trips the breaker? No more heat. And when the light switch gets flicked off, things go dark. When you stop the power source, the source of energy, things just don't work. This is exactly my point and what we have done with Aquashade and algae. You see, sunlight is the energy source for algae, not nitrogen or phosphorus. Those are important nutrients, but even those take sunlight to make them usable and be able to incorporate it in the building blocks of algae. Sunlight drives the largest component of the cell biomass, which is carbon. As the sun energy is captured, it's used to reduce carbon dioxide to those organic carbon building blocks through that photosynthetic process. That is the most limiting factor to the biomass that algae can achieve. Because, aside from water, carbon's the largest component of the algal biomass you're seeing out there. Now, you may have seen this shading concept play out in other management options, such as pool covers or shade cloths or these shade balls, but these are not good. You know, if you actually want to use your pond, you really can't use them if you have those out there on them, and they're certainly not good for the wildlife either. And they may not even work. A lot of cyanobacteria may grow attached to those types of things. So what we did is specifically design a blend of benign, non-toxic dyes that self-disperse through the water and turn the lights off. You can just pour it in around the edge, and sure, it makes the pond look beautiful, and if you just want to use it for that purpose, that's perfectly fine, but the technology inside goes so much deeper. You see, the specific blend and concentration of dyes in Aquashade are designed to align and block specific key wavelengths of light that algae need. All right, this is cool. Let me give you a little visual of this. This is pretty exciting. Here's an image of the chlorophyll A pigment. Now, this is present in most types of algae and cyanobacteria and the dominant light harvesting pigment. It is responsible for all the green you see out there because it reflects those wavelengths of light, but it absorbs in different spectrums of light. Now, here it is. Here's the absorbent spectrum of chlorophyll A. Now, let me show you the absorbent spectrum of the dyes we have in Aquashade. Pretty neat, huh? Now I'm going to overlay them and bam! Just like that, we flipped the switch on algae. We took their energy source, we unplugged them. However you want to think of it, no longer can those light wavelengths be used to drive the growth of algae because we blocked them first with Aquashade. This is huge and a key part of algal management. Flip the switch on algae, knock their lights out with Aquashade. Thanks for tuning in to this special mini-series event on Aquashade, and be sure to catch the other ones. And if you need to get your hands on some, well, reach out to us. We'll be right back.